Anyway, guys, welcome to race number 13 here at Eurospeedway. And I am Chris Eagle here. Anyway, guys, welcome to Eurospeedway here, which is not on the IS schedule because apparently they say it sucks, but according over here for Summer Jam, let's give it a shot because why the hell not? Well, anyway, guys, this is the first race of the European Tour 2. Yes, 2. Yes, no joke. This is our second European Tour in this series history, and we be going to tracks like of course here we also be going to Wales, and there's a debate between a Spa and another track somewhere, but I will inform you about that later on. And we also got Finland at Karjala, if I pronounced it correctly, which I think I did. And finally, we're going to Rockingham, UK, which is a beautiful sight to see, I guess. Anyway, guys, that is the European tour schedule as of right now, except for the third race, of course. But other than that, that's all we got right now. Anyway, let's go for some quick news for a bit. Anyway, guys, last race, which is 170. Joe Richards has won the 170. I know, huh? No joke. She was the class of the field originally, huh? And the first ever green-white checker in the 170. So it was a fantastic run for her. And she is breaking out of her shell big time. Oh wait. Yeah, never mind. I don't know what the hell I'm doing in my life. But anyway, there's really not much I can say and do, but my Joe Richards, she was a class, and the final also was absolutely crazy because we even got a Subaru in the top 15, and we got other drivers who made their first attempt. What the fuck am I saying anymore? Kind of the first way back, like Sanford and Warhoy. Well, Warhoy, he got first race back since the 170, and Sanford his first race back since Indianapolis. Both got good runs, like 170. It's one of the best races of the season, honestly, for me at least. But other than that, they're all good. As for the points, sounds like Tessa, he got a 5-point lead, at least I think, over Sean Angel. At least I think so, because I can't remember shit right now. But other than that, everything's all good. After that, after Angel for 5 points, we got Nick Pelukis with 29, excuse me. Will Lewis with 68, excuse me. 89 for Ryder Smith, and that is it. So basically, it's a top 5. Other dark horses could be Young, Richard, Shelley, Collins, and I don't know. It kind of depends on how the second half is going to go, because the second half tends to be fucking stupid. Anyway, guys, that's all we got, and we're gonna get to our starting lineup. Anyway, guys, the post of the race is Ryder Smith. Yes, no joke. Ryder Smith is closing down on the top four. Let's see what he's gonna do. So in second is Dick Bassinger, who have botched the 170. Played damn badly. Mechanical problem, I think. So in third is Dylan Young, who even got a rust run. Then Jake. And then we got fourth, we got PJ Williams, who incredibly also botched 170. Alright, just holy damn crap. And then we got Nasser Simonacci in fifth, who also didn't have a good one and 170 as well. So yeah, it's basically four top five didn't have a good one and 170. Sixth, on the other hand, Colin Collins, he had a good one. At 170, it's only 6. Falafin at 7th, he did not get a top 10 though, but he did put up one of the best performances yet this season. And then we got 8 of Kipper for Virginia. I have no idea how the hell he actually been up here, but sure. And I have now a 9th, who is still struggling, sadly. And my top 10 is Greg Marshall, the highest spec car driver. Anyway, guys, that's all we got, and let's see you guys for the green flag now, shall we?
Alrighty then, so the pace car has said, fuck that shit, I'm out. And now we are getting ready to go green flag here. Our Eurospeedway here, Ryder Smith and Jake Bassinger are going to be above Galea's down. Also note the symmetry forgot to say the commentary, so that's pretty cool. I don't know what happened, but I gotta see if I'm a sub anyway. Anyway guys, we are green here at Eurospeedway in Germany, I guess. I never even said the name correct name at all, I just said the damn track thing. Heck. Anyway, enough of that bullshit. Miles Smith has jumped to a fair lead a little bit. This track has a lot of suck up, as you can tell, because this is a kind of bit of a speedback type of racing, but it uses no place anyway, so it requires some skill as it has three turns. So it kind of takes some skill and some mechanical grip as well. It seems like PJ Williams, he's trying to take the lead at turn number 3, but by the time he is going to get the run off of turn 3. Turn 1 and 2 is a pretty good passing spot for inside line, but turn 3 is a good line defender. That's PJ Williams, he is going to dive bomb the corner at turn number 3 here. We even went like 4 wide for a moment. But now let's go check the back here. Everybody's being normal right now. Like, everybody is in the same pack. Yes, including Princess Purple, more people, yes, still in this pack. Boy, I never saw Pelicans dive bomb the corner, but he backed off. Like this is how close you get to a speedway. Like, it's like everybody is so bunched up, you can't pass, like you can't go anywhere. It's like a bigger traffic jam. That's basically the whole nature of this whole track. I don't know, it's crazy, huh? Well, they didn't even hit my 4-wide in the corner. Boy, and Angel and LaTerza are actually up there right now. As PJ Williams, he takes the lead of the race. And now Triangle is now going to battle out for the lead against Ryder Smith and PJ Williams. And turn number 3. But now he's trying to make another move, but... Oh my god, that did not went too well, but Angel, he actually took the lead of the race here. And now he has to fend off from his teammate. And LaTerza as well, who is making a dive bomber move at turn number 1. He got past Angel, but... Oh, actually, no, never mind. He's just up upset with Angel and Cavanaro. Cavanaro and Angel are getting a lot of speed from the corner there. And so LaTerza, he gets the lead, but Greg Marshall, he actually pushed PJ Williams there. Forces a fourth situation, and there has been contact. There's contact between Henry Williams and... I don't know who. That is a little bit bad. We need to see what happened. Tight race in here, folks. Yeah, him. There's also Henry Sampa. He actually went down low, just trying to squeeze on Henry Sampa. But Sampa's trying to make a dive bomber. Williams is trying to squeeze him out. Rossi, he was not keeping his line straight a little bit. It seems like Rossi actually came down. I think he came down on Henry. He must have came down on Henry Williams, and there was a slight contact. And Rossi's wheel end pushed Henry Williams into Henry Sampa, which causes Henry Sampa to spin out Henry Williams. So it's kind of a bit of a basic deal, I think. Everybody isn't giving anybody in the room whatsoever. Like, this is a very tight track. Henry Sample gets back on the track safely, which is a good thing because this track has some problems. As Henry Williams himself, he actually saves the car while he was spinning, so it was honestly a good save on his part. Like, he did not hit the wall, and he did not went back, and he did not went up the track. So that's some good. I guess it's some good car control, but. Oh, no, that's all I got. Anyway, guys, let's see you guys back live. Greg Marshall, he's trying to fight off against PJ Williams, but, Greg Williams. No. Oh, God. PJ Williams, Greg Marshall, he actually got that bad run at turn 3, and he actually lost the lead there to PJ Williams. And now there's now a 3-wide battle for the lead. Almost. And Trigger's gonna make a dive bombing move. But however, he did not get to inside. And somehow he is going to take the lead of the race here. He's trying to take the lead. And he got the lead. PJ Williams, he did not have the outside grip as he wanted to. So I'm not so much is leading the race here. And PJ Williams, he really needs a good run here in order to stay in the championship hunt. Williams, he was a bit loose there off the corner a little bit, but he was okay there. And I also saw a very interesting meme over there. It's not really a meme, but John Johnston, he's actually up here. He's trying to fight for second place right now. And he's actually going to get the move done, I think. But he's trying to set up the move. He got past Simonacci. Can he get past Jay Bassinger? And he does so. So John Johnston takes the lead. He didn't take the lead. He got to second place. So what an outstanding run for him. And also Soul Keeper is in the top 10. What is this? Yeah, 3-wide battle over here. They actually got away from the pack a little bit, but not by much though. As they actually 4-wide in the corner. Lewis and LaTerza, that they are door banging against each other a little bit, but no foul. But we all good here. As Nabasa, he needs to keep the lead away from LaTerza. Oh god, what was that in behind? Between Smith, Binky, and Marshall there, I saw that. And so Akiba, he is fighting on the outside wall, is he? Oh boy, that didn't even give him much grip at all. As LaTerza, he's gonna take the lead away from the passenger very easily. No challenge whatsoever. And also the fact that he needs to lead a lap here, so the reason why because Triangle, he actually led a lap, so he needs to negate the points gain. As Chan, he's actually up here. That's a very interesting sight to see. Maybe he's trying to put LaTerza to the lead. But nope, Chan just has to go low. There's actually Brock here. Oh god, that did not even look normal at all. That's not even normal. But so Chan is going to make a move on Bassinger and LaTerza. That's a 4-wide move. But Trigger took a tighter line, so he is going to get a bad run off the corner. And that's a contact between Chan and Trigger. And everybody is in a big old traffic jam. Like, this is basically what Speed Race is. This is the type of racing you would normally see, I guess. Maybe not enough for y'all, but it's something, I guess. Here's our champion! Not really a champion, but she's our 170 winner. Joe Richards, she's having problems getting past through this boggle downfield. This is a very difficult field to pass because, number one, your spirit is a very difficult track to pass due to the lanes. But number two, everybody's racing a little bit aggressive, so she needs to be patient, I guess. Terza and Williams and Chan, they are still battling out against each other. It seems like Ava's starting to calm down a little bit as Tyler is starting to kick in a little bit right now. Oh my god, what the hell was that drastic lane change from having now? Like, seriously? PJ Williams, he's trying to fight off against LaTerza, but LaTerza, he gets a good run off the corner. But let's see if he's going to keep it, and he does! LaTerza, a good run off the corner, has defended from PJ Williams. Now Williams now has Diva Maxwell Chan, who gets a good run at the inside line. And Chan has now had a battle against RJ Manson, who has the worst luck in history, I must add. And Angel is back in the picture. He's trying to pass Chan, but Henry Sample, it kind of spooked him a little bit. That's not PJ Williams, he's now trying to take the lead away from Sasa Terza. This is another battle of lead between these two. And there has been contact, and that is Henry Sample now getting turned. Now Henry Sample has turned Henry Ray of the now, Dylan Young has took out a Henry Sanford. And no conscience, by the way. That's very stupid.
Let's see here.
John Johnson's got a little bit loose, off of turn number one. Let's see, frame by frame. Here's John Johnston. Dylan Young has, he's actually too close to Henry Sanford's bumper. And then John Johnson's car got a bit loose. Let's see. Young kind of lit off Henry Sanford, but John Johnson's car is, his car was but unstable off the corner, and that pushed Henry Sanford into Dylan Young, which forces Young to turn his teammate. So I think that was a racing incident right there, I think. So I'm under 1-2-1 with Henry Williams.
Boy, Chan and Angel battling out for the lead here. John Johnson, after his shenanigans, he's actually up and trying to take the lead away. And can he do it? Can he actually lead a lap? Let's see here. We are coming to the final corner. And John Johnston, I think John Johnston, he's going to lead a lap here. Yes, he does. And another driver who's actually up here is Alex Puckle. I don't know what the hell he came from. A great march, he seriously shoved Alex Puckle off. Made him very, very loose there. But yeah, John Johnson actually led a lap. I believe that he actually led a lap for the first time in the Sim Gym series. Officially. Boy, Saga Lobby, he's actually all over the back bumper. Sounds like Tezza, and there has been contact! That's between Williams and Fingai. Boy, that turned out to be a disaster almost. Boy, everybody's even racing on these old tires, huh? And also, I forgot that Dan Smith also has the biggest gap right now of anybody so far. Like, what the hell? As we are in stack at 5 wide for a moment. We're actually 4 wide. One row deep. Like, that is insane. Like, if they keep it out like this, Daniel Smith, he's actually going to run away with this race because everybody's battling out way too much. Oh my goodness. So Daniel Smith is having a good race. Sean Angel and Sons of Tezza, they're actually both close to each other, so that's going to be interesting to see. That points battle is going to be very interesting. I'd like to have the fact that Puzzle's Cloak is somehow still up here. There's Jackson Thomas in the back. Both of the Ripple crossing them doing well. Chica, he's just having a terrible time. And so is Nick, he's actually good in the points. He needs to get something going because if not, Angel and LaTerza are both gonna pull away. For Ruffin, having one of the best performances of his career, it did not pay off him at 170 as he was actually left out and finished in top 15, not in top 10, sadly. Let's go up the field. Marlon Smith is somehow not being as aggressive as I thought. At least not right now, at least. But it's James Dalton. He's doing pretty well. A crappy start, but he kind of picked it up and then he kind of tipped off to that. And Daniel Smith, he's still holding out at least, surprisingly. Holding all sorts of Tezza. Now Tezza, he is going to challenge Daniel Smith for the lead here right now. Let's see here, coming into turn number two. Both drivers there are both pretty good. Is Innocent can use his outside line to try and defend off the man himself? Nope, it did not. Dan Smith, he got a bit too tight there, but no! The Tezza lead a lap, but now Dan Smith, he pulls the crossover move. And Daniel Smith takes the lead back from the Tezza, and that has been the wreck! Alex Puckle gets turned! Moore gets turned as well! Oh, Carl Collins, some energy now smoking! And Carl Collins is still in the middle of the track! Sanchez has no idea how to go! Jason Puckle and Soul Keeper are dead! Especially Jason, and gets some more SMRG perfect each other! What the absolute fuck happened there? And Marlon Smith, the poster that gets involved. Ma'am, what the fuck just happened? And him and Sampa is in the pits. I do believe that this is a scheduled pit stop, I think, for him. So yeah, green flag pit stop is what about to happen. As Daniel Smith takes the lead of the race. Let's see what happens. Almost Pogo was having a good run. He was trying to do what he did at the 170, just trying to get a good run, but it seems like James Dorn, he actually went up the track into Alex Pogo, basically almost kind of bit of a diabolical move. Let's see a little bit close. Yep, it seems like James Dorn, he actually diabolical the corner way too much, and he just took up and he took out Alex Pogo in the process. And Miles Smith gets involved and gets some more. He panicked a little bit, and he did not. He touched Alex Pogo, and then he got loose. Went up to Devin Young, and then he took out James Dolan in the process. But somehow Dolan still saves it, even though the Dolan actually made contact with two cars. And man's almost got involved, so make that three cars. Or oh, four calls now. God damn it. And fortunately, Carl Collins, though, he also got involved with Alistair Shenanigans. That's Foster Duncan. He narrowly avoided missing that. And so is Chan. And boy, kind of looks twice again for the Manson boys. As two of the drivers are got involved in a wreck, Pierce Bevel almost got taken out in the process. And this could have been a much bigger wreck because there was like 12 cars in this pack, so I'm very, very shocked that no one actually got a big incident. Now here's the rear part. Carl Collins trying to get to pit road, and so Kibray, he's trying to avoid Carl Collins, as he could have done so at the high line, but instead, he chose to go low into Raul Sanchez and Chica Lubia. Chica saved it, but Sanchez did not, and Jason and Kibray got taken out in the process. Jason got some things going on with him, and Sanchez has slammed on the roof of Jason Pogo. It looks very violent, but the Moss Corolla isn't as drastic as you think it is. It may look bad on camera, but the speed is not what you think it is. We are going to take a phenomenal look, and it is a 80 miles per hour impact. High race speed, but it is roof damage, so it could be pretty serious though. So, of course, Jason Pogo will be taken to the incubator as a precautionary for any head trauma. Hopefully, she'll be okay though. Now though, another fucking issue. What the fuck happened to Simonacci? Nope. It's getting more ran over now to Simonacci, just being a damn idiot. Okay, whatever that's supposed to mean. Wow, so yeah, get some more has ran over Simonacci. Get some more, he could actually continue this race because he not too much contact, but instead he basically fucked himself in the race. Good, it actually benefited Henry Williams, so that's good. Anyway guys, let's go back. Okay, here drivers out of the race. We got Carl Collins, Sori Kibre, Nelson Simonacci get some more, and Jason Pogo are out of this race. My god, these poor drivers just having crappy luck. Simonacci and Jason, boy, these two drivers are just having the best luck. Excuse me. And now we got 37 cars, and they're all on the lead lap. Well, almost. Your leader is not Henry Samper. Your leader is Sasa Terza, and then that is Daniel Smith, Luke Trigger, John Jaston, Rick Marshall, Sean Angel, PJ Williams, Alan Campanaro, we got Jeffrey Fingai, Dylan Young, Bossy Duncan, James Shirley, Bima Sakuraba, K-Papa Jr., P. Peter Spatler, Jay Passenger, Michael Falafin, Lou Lewis, Chris Lubia, Hemian Fitzwater, William Block, Ashley Block, oh god, okay. Nick Pellicles, RJ Manson, Princess Puck on 25th, Chris Dodd, Chica Lubia, Joe Richards, Marco Rossi, and Maxwell Chairman on the points. Anyway guys, that is basically the whole field. I'm surprised that it is not a lot bigger than that. So yeah, let's just get this race underway now. But anyway guys, we are green here at Eurospeedway. Hemi and Stefan gets a good jump off. This is an opportunity of a quick caution, but however though, anybody's not a double foul or even 3-1 right now, as this is just a restart right now. Anybody has pitted. So the Taylor took the lead away from Daniel Smith in the pit stops, but now Daniel Smith is now hunting down on the Taylor. Well, when I'm saying he now passes him. Oh my god, oh boy. I thought Daniel Smith is gonna choke for a moment, but he's okay. But Henry Smith, he gets the gun run off the corner there, which allows Salsa Tessa trying to fight against Daniel Smith there. And Smith, he is still side by side, lift to 17. Still side by side to 17. Daniel Smith is still keeping it in the middle there. Luke Trigger, he is to his inside. Three wide there. Luke Trigger, he's trying to make a dive bomb move. Let's just do some drops in the back for a moment and just trying to see who's actually off the pace. And apparently, wow, that's some bullcrap I just saw. I don't know, that's a personal issue, but whatever. But anyway, Daniel Smith takes the lead here. Ryan Smith, I don't know where the hell he's at, I think he's in the back, since he got more damage. I'm surprised that Beamer's like Obama is somehow still up here. Like, what the fuck? But he has never got a top 10. He's actually, I don't know how the hell to say this, but he's even behind a couple of part-time drivers. That's how bad he is right now in the season. But however though, he does have the talent, and I guess the car is just trying to get a good run. As we get back for teammates between Angel and Cavanaugh. Cavanaugh, he needs a good run here. His 170 just got completely botched, and I think can make up his season. I think that Cavanaugh just wants to win this season, I think. As he is now going 3-1 for the lead between Smith and Trigger. As Trigger, oh boy, his car got horribly tight. As Daniel Smith takes the lead. No, not yet though. He's trying to take the lead. Let's see if he's going to squeeze him out. Nope. Cavanaugh is still at his inside. Trigger's gonna try again. Bossy Duncan is still up here. He actually went from all the way down to be in the top 5 right now. Oh my gosh. Passenger is being aggressive to Saga Lava. Passenger needs a good one as well. Just trying to keep his spot in the team. But usually Passenger is usually a second half driver, but he needs to stop being a second half driver and just be a foreign championship contender. As Passenger, he is now making a 4-wire move, which it could work. But however though, he has to fight off against Sean Angel, because Livia is also up here in third. That is a tight 4-wire battle for a position in the top 10. I don't even know what position is at. And it looks like Chris Lubia is not going for the lead. No, not quite though. As Angel, he actually swings out wide. Very, very, very wide. And that is going to kill his momentum. Sakurabi is trying, he's trying everything right now. We're not going single file for almost three cars. Trigger does not have to draft. The passenger is still leading the way here. Thank God the chairs are up here. Now this is a 5-car single file. That's actually the closest time we get. This is the largest single file race that we got so far. Like, that's probably a shot highlight for me, at least. Now, Olivia is not going for the lead here. And he is... Can't get the run in! He did not have a good turn number one here. That's better, he is going to pull away. He seems to have the aerodynamics. And he is... Maybe still trying. He's not going to do it here. He needs to wait until to turn number three. He is getting pressure from Campanella pretty soon. He is going to try to get out of turn number three. The side by side still. 48. Olaf is actually up here. Olaf is capable for his junior. That's not even damn normal. As Campanella, he is making an aggressive move now. Trying to get past the 40. He's now going to, and Olivia is not behind Passenger, so that he can defend from Campanella. You know, a hard fought battle for the lead here right now between Olivia and Campanella and Passenger. Olivia is trying to bring that momentum from the 170 into the European Tour too, so he is trying his absolute best. Like Campanella, he just wants to win at least one race this season. Passenger, he just needs to find a way of how to get better at these damn tracks. I swear to God, he has no luck at all. And that is Sanchez, that is not good. He's actually awfully slow. And that is a wreck-up ball car there, so maybe Sanchez can help the 40. And it's gonna help that the Tez is not battling against the 40. As oh my god, that was incredibly tight. And Lubia, he's still following Passenger's draft, but Kilburn for Junior, he's not going for the lead now. And there has been a wreck! Oh my god! Sanchez had caused a huge wreck! Oh my god! No, that's not good. Binky, hit me a Fitzwater, hit me a Sampa gets involved in another wreck. What a fucking shot that Sampa can't even get, cannot even avoid another hit. And Chan got involved as well. Wow, that is big time implications. And several criterias. Maybe Marco Rossi did something, I don't know, but I honestly was a black car doing something. I don't know. Let's see. We gotta see what happened as we are gonna have less than 10 laps to go for the green flag.
Let's
run.
See here.
Anybody is going 3-1 pretty normally. Oh, it's Henry the Fitzwater. But then he got into excuse me. Sabaleta. She got involved with Sanchez. Let's see the replay. Oh, it seems like Sanchez either tipped his line or Fitzwater was going way too fast. We need to see a roof cam. Frame by frame. I don't see Sanchez going up or down the truck. I really don't see that at all. It's a very weird incident, so we have to take a look at that post-race, trying to determine what is that. It's not just has something to do with him going down the track on the lap cars. He will get a penalty. It matters if he actually goes down the track, as we got a lot of cars involved in this incident. Yep, and then we got Fitzwater involved, Chris Don involved, like, I swear to god, Don had like no fucking luck. Chan, Sally did not, did Chan actually avoid that? No, he did avoid that. Impossible. Oh my god, look at that smoke. We gotta see what Chan is. Looking at. What the fuck? Did you see that? Did the guy see James Dalton? He just freaking punched it. He just punched it through. Holy hell! How the hell did he not get involved in that? He could have been unscathed from that. But it looks like Chan did not get involved in the wreck, but I don't know, it's pretty strange, but anyway guys, and Princess somehow avoided the wreck. That's not good. But anyway guys, that's all we got, and let's see guys for the next pack. 42's on this race, the 24 is a lap down, so we gonna have about 8 more laps left for this race. This is lap number 42. We are going to have 8 laps to go once we cross the line here. So we got Sasha Tezza, Jay Bassinger, Kepo, Virginia Kazulia, Dana Smith, Jeffrey Fingard, Greg Marshall, Alan Campanello, Martha Falafet, and Joe Richards in the top 10. Oh, no. Where the hell did she came from? As we are going through the field here. Yeah, see, I know, like, that's very strange. Because she's not going to get points. It's a little stupid. Chica has a fend off against Princess Pinky. What is this? This is so weird. Minus Matt, boy, he's actually outside the points, so he's only guaranteed 10 points. And James Shudley and Purple got involved in this. I guess. Hey guys, Zaza Tezza. He has never won a race this season. I know, right? It's pretty shocking. And he is a points leader. Angel, I have. Angel is not even in the top 10, so this is... So Angel has a problem right now, as he can't even get past LaTerza right now. Well, anyway guys, we are green here at Eurospeedway for the final 8 laps of this race. Maybe. LaTerza gets a good start, really kind of botched out start. He botched out start a little bit, but he is not going to... Fight for the lead against LaTerza, excuse me. Kilburn Fire Jr. had a shot for his second career win. Daniel Smith, he is looking for more right now. Fang Guy, he is looking for his second career win. Marshall is not looking low now on Fang Guy. Passenger takes the lead. And we actually almost 4-1 at turn number 3 here. Greg Marshall, he actually almost went to the inside line almost, the most inside part of the line, and they actually screwed his momentum a lot. And Olivia, he is not trying to fight against the passenger right now. He is having problems all day just trying to figure out how to pass him. The side drift is not working for him. And Olivia, he is sticking his nose in. He might be getting his 5 points maybe. He has never led a lap here this season, I don't think. Oh wait, he did. Yeah, he did. I lied. And the 40 takes the lead here with only 6 laps to go, but he's getting challenged by him. Oh my god, they're 4-wide. 4-wide for the lead. And that cost will be a lot of positions there. The outside line is not looking too well. As we got Campbell for a junior. And for Longfin, and Joe Vitches is up here as well. Angel and LaTerza are actually right next to each other. They are even in one position within each other right now. This is a pretty good battle for the championship lead now. Primo Sagarabo took the title line at the inside line, which caused him a lot of momentum there. Let's see some drivers in the back. It seems like I don't know how the hell Henry Williams is in 20th, but what a comeback for him, honestly. Let's give him a credit about that, honestly. At least I think it's 20th. But otherwise, what a good comeback for him. But anyway, we now gonna have 4 laps to go. But for Laughlin, he wants to have redemption for the 170 after a brilliant performance at 170. Burnful is going to spoil the party. There is a big gap. There is a 4 attempts gap right now between the top 2 and the pack behind them. We are going to take a spectator view right now. Like, look at this. Like, you can see that the inside line is already the outside line can down something I can handle. Turn number two pretty well. Joe Bridges, she is not going for second place over Falafin. That's not gonna help Falafin at all. As Bridges, she is gonna try to dive bomb the corner for Falafin, but that did not work. Falafin is looking, he is now looking in for the lead here, maybe. We only got three laps. We only got 2.5 laps to go for this race right now. Because Angel, he's actually going, he's not going for a position on Kevin now. There's contact between Pelicris and Marshall. Pelicris actually up here. Where the hell did he came from? LaTerza is not even in the top 10 right now. Joe Angel in the top 5. Where the hell is out LaTerza? 2 laps to go here. A lot of racing, there's also a lot of racing that can be done. Kent Burford Jr. is right there on Falafin. And he is going to make a move. Oh my god. Sakababa has a shot to win as well. What is going on with this race? We only have one more lap to go here at US Speedway. White flag is in the air. Cavanaro, he has a shot to make a dive bomb and move. He makes a dive bomb and move for the lead here. Falafin gets left out to dry. Kipper Ford Jr. is not a slot with Alan Cavanaro. Oh my god, Devin Young is here for some strange kind of reason. Falafin is not losing it. Kipper Ford Jr. lost the lead. Side by side for the win. Oh my god, Devin Young has pushed Alan Cavanaro! 3 wide for the win, and Alan Cavanaro takes the win here at Eurospeedway! That was a very interesting finish. Whoa, that was a finish and a half. Boy, Falafin is feeling frustrated, I bet. Oh my god. That was very interesting. A lot of tempos are flowing as drivers. Oh, there's been a caution and there's been a wreck. And somebody got wrecked. I don't know who. And Burnford got involved in it. That's always good. As it kind of looks like. Oh, I don't know about that. I have no idea if Falafin was being too immature or not. We gotta see. We gotta see if it's a, a competition at the final lap of the race. Because right now by Falafin, he actually wants to win, in the European Tour, but... He got passed by 2 cars, which kind of made him a bit irritated there. And all of a sudden, Joe Richards was there, and so was Demi Young, so he actually lost another 2 more positions there. And look at that finish. 3 Y. And Richards almost got second. What a back-to-back podium for Joe Richards. She almost got second too. She almost got second. If she actually would have got second, oh boy, she could have been a championship contender maybe coming up. But no, that's good. But I do think that she's gonna lose a couple of ground, especially with Cavanaro in the race. Maybe, I don't know about that. I gotta wait and see. But look at that finish though. Like Cavanaro, what a run from him off of turn number 1. As Demi Young, he actually got the drive and he actually found a last turn punch at the end along with Joe Richards. Let's see if there was a contact. Like Cavanaro was trying to He's trying to block Dylan Young. Oh, wow. There was actually almost contact, but Kappa now, look at him sliding! Look at him sliding off the corner. I thought Kappa is gonna lose the lead, but no, he did not. He was drifting in the corner. Boy, oh boy. That was a thriller. That was another thriller. Almost kind of like Fontana from last season, after 170 as well. As there are some post-race shenanigans, I don't know what happened there. I don't know if Richard was clear or not, but it was pretty goofy, I do gotta say. Yeah, I think Richard just went down. I think that Richard was being too goofy there. That is a bit weird. But whatever though. It's a gentleman's and ladies agreement, so yeah, that's cool. According to what I was saying, like, it's post-race, so anybody can just, like, you know, screw around. But anyway, guys, I think that's all we got for the race, though. So yeah, I'm Kevin Nalo. Gets his first win of the season, 6R time. I know, like, Kevin Nalo, what a legend at the Sim Gym Series. Now, that second is Dylan Young, third is Joe Richards, fourth Daniel Smith, fifth is Rafa Falafin, sixth Kipper Virginia, seventh must like a robber. 8th is PJ Williams, 9th is Foster Duncan, top 10 is John Jackson. Andrew finished 11th, and Terza finished in 20th. I believe that Sasa Terza lead the most laps out of any driver, so he will gain. So I think that the points will be for Sean Angel's favor, but it's going to be a small gap still between Angel and LaTerza. Perky's finish in a pretty tough 14th position. That's gonna put him closer to LaTerza a little bit, but not by much. Not by much at all, I don't think. He might gain like 2 points on him since Sasa Terza had led a lap as well as lead the most laps. Plus his Puckle got 4 points. What the fuck is this? Chris Olivia actually blocked in 16th and 17th, that's not bad. Marco Rossi in 18th. Well, that's quite interesting to see. That's a pretty good run, honestly, especially the season he has having. Oh boy. Split car might go to the 26. Boy, Manson is having no luck whatsoever. He keeps on getting in the last bit of the points. Henry Williams in 21st. What a good comeback for him. It's not a great one, but it's a good one. Like 18 points is not that bad. Must be fair. Especially with a lot of drivers screwing up. Hey guys, that's all we got for right now. You saw the rest of the points. I'm Icarus Eagle here. Next time we be going to Wales. I know, huh? After this crappy post commentary race. Hey guys, I'm Icarus Eagle, and I'm gonna see you guys soon. Hey guys, that's the time for now.